HCCS, Mr. Skorecki. Heard that we're going to start getting ready for the fall break. Great. Know what Thanksgiving's really about? Let me tell you a little story about Sarah Josepha Hale. She's the real reason we celebrate Thanksgiving. I know you've heard about the Indians and the Pilgrims, and even though neither of those people are called that, Sarah over here is the reason we celebrate it. She was so obsessed with this little holiday in New England that she wrote to the president, who was Lincoln at the time, and said, "Hey, this is so great, you need to make it a national holiday. Also, don't even pay attention to the fact they didn't eat turkey. Make it with turkey. Kick out the venison and the fish and the eels. Use stuffing and cranberry sauce." It's like if people from Philadelphia said, "Hey, we like Cheese Whiz on everything, so Pittsburghers, put it on your pimani sandwich with the fries and coleslaw. Isn't that fun?" Can't just blame her, we gotta thank President FDR. See, even though Sarah got her way, and we now celebrate his national holiday, FDR decided, because he got some messages from other people, that he would change Thanksgiving to the fourth Thursday in November. And you think, oh, that's great, so we can get time off? No, he did it so we can be greedy and get extra time to shop for Xmas.
Hooray.
And lastly, remember, there's no such thing as an Indian, except if you're talking about the people from the country of India. The Wampanoag Native Americans were actually the main reason for the holiday. You see, the Pilgrims, when they landed, didn't know how to farm right. They were basically eating deer corn, breaking their teeth, and starving. First winter they were here, most of them died of starvation. So, the Native Americans, the Wampanoag tribe, went in, taught them how to farm, and when the Pilgrims were like, "Hey, thanks, we're gonna just sit around in church all day, because that's what we do on Thanksgiving," they said, "You know, typically when this happens before winter, we like to have a big feast and raise our community together." And they said, "That's great." Until right after that holiday, they started murdering, smallpoxing, and trying to get them off their lands. Happy Thanksgiving Day break, kids.
Hey, welcome back, Achievement House. I'm Mrs. Throckmorton.
And I'm Mrs. Batis.
And let's start off with our Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hi, students. It's time to get creative. Don't forget about our winter Moodle Doodle. Your submissions are due on December 1st, and then after we come back from the holidays, or from our break, we are going to be
voting,
so don't forget to vote. Your submissions can be scanned and uploaded, so think about creative ways you can do photography, painting, drawing, or any type of interesting submission that you can think of. So don't forget to enter December 1st.
All right, and also December 1st, we have our lip sync contest due, so if you're working on one of those music videos, finish it up and get it to Mrs. Simpson.
This is Rebel Underground. We have audio, but no video.
Sorry to interrupt your announcements, but I have a message from District 13. Mockingjay has been released, and it is just as good as the other films. For those of you who read the book, you will not be disappointed. It is a true adaptation. If you didn't read the book, shame on you! Go right now and buy the Hunger Games series and read it, because they're awesome. But you're still going to know what's going on if you see the movie, especially if you've seen the other two Hunger Games, because Mockingjay picks up right where we left off. The film is awesome. Highly suggest you go check it out this holiday break. You have plenty of time. I will warn you, though, no spoiler alert, but I'm just saying, there's a bit of a cliffhanger. Even if you read the book and you know what's coming, you're like, "No, please don't stop it here." But they did. So we gotta wait another year, but it's totally worth it. Go check it out, support the rebellion.
Whoa! That was a little unusual. Back to our regular schedule though. Make sure that those lip sync video submissions are school appropriate and send a positive message.
And don't forget, we have a short week. End of the pod on Wednesday, and no school on Thursday and Friday. So if you show up on Thursday, we won't be there.
And get all those assignments submitted. It's end of the pod. We have also a jump rope for the heart coming up after break, December 2nd and 3rd. Look below for the details in some of our centers where you can join into the fun and enjoy this video. Don't forget us to like us on Facebook.
Follow us on Twitter.
We found out that Brenna had a heart condition when she was born, and the pediatrician came to check her out, and he says, "Wow, I noticed a heart murmur." And I'm like, "A heart murmur? What does that mean?" A normal heart goes lub-dub, lub-dub. Brenna's heart went lub-swoosh, lub-swoosh. So it was a different beat. The sound indicated that she had a hole in her heart. It was about 5 to 6 millimeters large, which doesn't seem like a lot, but when it's in a baby heart, it still allows the blood to flow in the wrong direction. When Brenna was 15 months, she had open heart surgery to fix the hole in her heart. They went in and they patched it, and that's how they corrected it. This was a scary time in our lives. Because Brenna had the surgery, she's able to jump rope, play soccer, play volleyball, run, do whatever she wants physically, supporting the American Heart Association through your donations.
Thank you to all the kids that have helped raise money for Jump Rope for Heart, because it's gone to help kids like me who have had heart problems.
Hey everyone, Mr. Dill here to tell you about Jump Rope for Heart, which is coming to a center near you in the first week of December. As you can see on the screen here, on Tuesday, December 2nd, we will be in York at 9 a.m. We will be in Reading at 11 a.m. and we will be in Allentown at 1 p.m. And that's all on Tuesday, December 2nd. Now on Wednesday, December 3rd, we will be at ATM at 9:30 a.m. and Generation Excellence at 12:30 p.m. And those are both Wednesday, December 3rd for ATM and Generation Excellence. Now for Jump Rope for Heart, we do jump roping activities for about 30 to 45 minutes, and we would like you to bring a donation for the American Heart Association. You can still participate even if you don't bring a donation, but if you do bring a donation, you can get one of these cool ducks. So we have the orange one here and the red one here. You also get a lanyard with your duck. Now, if you are the highest donator in all of Achievement House, you have a chance to get the Super Duck. The Super Duck is for the highest donator at Achievement House. Right now, our highest student donation is $8. So if you bring more than $8, you have a chance to get the Super Duck. Our second highest donator will get a Jump Rope for Heart t-shirt. It's not the t-shirt that I have on right now. That would just be gross. But anyway, you'll get a brand new t-shirt if you're the second highest donator. So Jump Rope for Heart, coming to a center near you in the first week of December.